In this example, we're given the universal set contains the lowercase letters a through j and sets a, b, and c are subsets. We want to give the elements in each of these sets here. Let's do this using a Venn diagram. So looking at the Venn diagram, we'll start with the innermost part, or this region here, where a, b, and c overlap. The elements that are in a and b and c would be in this region here. So looking at our subsets a, b, and c, notice how each of these sets do contain the element e. So the element e would be in this region here. Now let's focus on, let's say, this region here, where this would contain the elements that are only in a and b. So looking only at set a and b, notice how element h is only in a and b. So h goes here. Next, let's look at this region here. This would be the elements that are only in b and c. Looking at only b and c, notice how j is the only element in both b and c. So j goes here. Now let's look at this region here. This contains the elements that are only in a and c. Looking at a and c, notice the element c, lowercase c, is the only element in a and c. Now that we have this information, we can now determine the elements that are only in a, only in b, and only in c. So looking back at set a, notice I is the only element that's only in a. So I goes here. Looking at b, notice d is the only element that's only in b. And now looking at c, notice g is the only element that's only in c. Now we're almost done, but remember the universal set are the lowercase letters a through j. So the elements that are in the universal set that are not in a or b or c should be listed in this rectangular region here. Notice lowercase a and b are not in sets a, b, or c. So those would be out in this region. And also f is not in a, b, or c. So we have an f out here as well. Now let's determine the elements in each of these sets. Just for review, union is given by this symbol here, which means or. Intersection is given using this symbol here, which means and. So for A intersect B intersect C, we're looking for the elements that are in A and in B and in C. That's actually where we started our Venn diagram here in the middle. And therefore A intersect B intersect C contains the element E. Next we have A union B union C, which would contain all the elements in A or B or C. All the elements in A or B or C would be all of the elements in this region here. So all the elements in the universal set except A, B, and F. So that would be C, D, E, G, H, I, and J. Next we have A intersect B and then union C. So let's first begin by determining the elements that are in A and B. Well, the elements in A and B would be where sets A and B overlap, which should be this region here. So A intersect B contains the elements E and H. So we want this set, union C. Well, the elements in C would be here. So we want the elements that are in this intersection here, or in C, which ends up being this region here, which would contain the elements CE, GHJ. And then finally, we have A union B intersection C. Let's first determine A union B, meaning when all the elements that are in A or B. So all the elements in A or B would be all the elements in this set here. So we want all these elements intersected with C. So let's circle set C, which would be here. We'll notice the intersection of these two sets, which is what we want, would be the elements in this region here. And therefore, this set contains C, E, J. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.